Welcome to a how-to on Zoom. In this video, we'll cover what is Zoom and how to use it as a host, going over the basics and special features available to hosts. First things first, what is Zoom? Zoom is a multi-platform meeting app. You can use it in your browser, on the phone, or via the app on your desktop, mobile devices, and tablet devices. Its multi-platform usage and simplicity has made it one of the most popular meeting apps today. Let's go over some of the basic keywords that I'll be using in this video. A meeting is what Zoom uses to describe the virtual conversation you're having online using the app. Now, for you, this may look a little bit different. It could be a lesson, a panel discussion, a webinar, or a performance, or something else. For the purposes of this video, I'll be using the term meeting just to make it simple and easy for everyone. The host is who creates the Zoom meeting, and typically, as it implies, hosts the meeting itself. And as a host, they will have special features to control and moderate the meeting. A moderator is in control of the meeting and, for example, can mute people and kick people out. In a sense, the host and the moderator have the same role. For bigger meetings, I would recommend to have two people, someone to be the actual host, the spokesperson for the event, and someone who is the actual Zoom host and moderating the event to ensure that it goes perfectly smooth. The participant is the invitee to the meeting. Now that you know what Zoom is and some of the basic keywords, let's go on how to actually use it. So to even host a meeting, you need to first set up a meeting. This can be done in your profile, which you'll find on the upper right-hand corner of the Zoom homepage, or via New Meeting in the app. Once you create a new meeting, you will be given a link, meeting ID, and a number, which then you can send to the participants. Participants do not require a Zoom account, but if they have one, upon receiving the link, the meeting will go into their schedule. Zoom is also compatible with Outlook and Google. Now that we're in the meeting, let's go over the basic features and moderator tools. Note that these tools are available to the host of the meeting and able to moderate the event. If you intend to have a separate moderator, ensure that they are the host of the Zoom meeting so they have these tools available to them. Microphone and video. Everyone from the host to the participant needs to turn on their audio and video in order to hear, but also to be heard and seen. Anyone can mute themselves and turn off their video, but only the moderator has the power to mute others and turn others' videos off. Security. The host can add or remove a waiting room and lock the meeting if and when necessary. Participants. This is a list of everyone in the meeting, which can be seen by everyone. In this, the host can mute and kick other people out, as well as assign co-hosts. Share screen. The possibility to share one screen is only possible if the host allows it. The host can mute other people in a way that they cannot share their screen, and there's certain limitations to how they can share their screen. Reactions are a fun way for participants to react using emojis, for example, to clap their hands. This is a great way for the audience to interact with the meeting without actually interrupting it. Chat. The chat box is open to everyone to send messages privately or to everyone in the meetings. Record. The host has the possibility to record the meeting and save it to their files. Everyone in the meeting will see that the meeting is being recorded. These are all the basic tools and features available to the host within a Zoom meeting. I hope this video was informative and that you're better equipped to host a Zoom meeting.